the Wave 3 Listening into Action process.
Yeah.
And we just wanted to hear a bit about what's changed within your team and in terms of the priorities you identified, the team identified, what's changed and the difference that has made to your working environment, the team and patient care.
Okay, when I started 3 months ago, that was in October, or 3 or 8 months ago, the office was very drafty and the heating wasn't on yet. So I used to work with other members of staff with our coats on, and it was so cold, so uncomfortable, and I kept reporting to estates the problems with heating, but nothing got done. It eventually became warmer. They put the pump, the heating out, so it eventually became warmer, and they came and sealed all the drafty windows, all drafty windows. So the office is now a joy to work in.
Okay, so I'm Fazine Haq. I'm a clinical lead for Sutton and Merton Personality Disorder Complex Needs Service. I'm also a consultant clinical psychologist. I've been working in South West London, St George's for the past 18 years, so very long history.
We were introduced to LIA recently. I've known of LIA since its inception and heard absolutely wonderful things that LIA has achieved. And we were fortunate enough to be invited to participate in the programme, in the initiative. And in our first meeting, LIA's first meeting with us, it was a fantastic experience for all of us, particularly myself as the clinical lead. And the experience was as if it was a team building day. It sort of was reminiscent of any good team building days that I've had. We were able to openly and honestly discuss where we're at, where we're heading, and look at what the needs were as well, what we needed to change in order to move forward. And so that was a very, very reassuring and exciting meeting for me personally. And I felt that was the atmosphere in the room for others as well. So we set, with LIA's initiative in mind, we set a number of goals. And one that I had personally had a lot of vested interest in, as it were, was to do with mainstream staff training, which is technically called frontline staff training. And we have successfully put staff training together. In fact, it's happening on the first of those days is happening on the 3rd of February, which we're very, very excited about. We've had a similar sort of training a good couple of years ago, very well received, and we're hoping that we will get a similar sort of reception from the attendees. This initiative is really about helping mainstream staff, frontline staff, So the objective of the frontline staff training is to improve capabilities of frontline staff so that they can deliver better care to the patients, the ones that they come across. We, of course, as I said earlier, we're a very small service and cannot reach up to every patient that needs our service. One way of working around is to improve the capabilities of frontline staff who come across the patients even before we do. It's an ambitious plan. However, it's very possible to achieve. It's been done in other other hospitals across the country. It's a well-established program and being delivered by a very one of the best, the best training service in the country, i.e. British Isles DBT. So we are very hopeful hoping that this will have a very big impact on the delivery of care to our patients with bursitis disorder.